If you want to know when to cut your spikes or your stems from your orchid, then this is the video for you. So let's get started. I want to talk about the dropping of the flowers. So a lot of the times your orchids will drop one at a time, or sometimes they will drop all of them almost all at once. And this is the indicator that it's time to focus on the what we like to call the vegetative stage. The vegetative stage, sorry about that. And this means we will focus on growing the roots and the leaves. By doing this, then we are encouraging the plant to hold more energy, so when it does spike, a lot of the growers like to say that we are building mass, and the more mass, then the bigger the spike and the more flowers. Now, that's not necessarily true, because I've seen plants with far less mass, meaning far less roots and leaves, produce more flowers than those ha that have a lot more roots and a lot more leaves. So, it's case by case. It's a lot more factors than just the mass. Other factors can be, the nutrition, the climate, stuff like that. But anyways, let's get to the cutting. We want to cut as close as we can to the base without damaging the leaves, and make sure we disinfect our cutting tool, because it may have other pathogens like bacterias or viruses, or funguses that we've used on plants prior to cutting these stems on our orchids. So make sure you use sterile, or disinfect them with alcohol or bleach, anything that you have. Okay, it doesn't have to be completely sterile, but it is recommended. So basically, what you want to avoid is on the freshly cutted wounds, don't add water, because the water can have those pathogens I was talking about. So be careful with that. And then also to make sure that we are treating our orchids the right way, then I like myself to mark the tip or the base of our growing leaf, which is the top one, because that's going to be our indicator. That's how we're going to know that our leaf is growing. I also like to mark the roots, the tip of the roots, because day by day I can, look at them and see how much they're growing, how much they're moving, or even how fast they're moving. You can compare one variety to the other and see which one's faster, which one is working better for you, or you could, have different techniques for different plants at once, and then you're going to be able to tell which technique is best for you. So I think that's a really good tip for you guys. You can see that the roots on this pot are looking really good. I'm looking at some roots that are actually growing from other roots that the orchid had in the past. Those lateral roots are really good, and just new roots that are finding themselves through the pot, through the bark, and this is a really, really good sign. And if you want to know how to water correctly, you could watch my other videos, and you're going to be able to tell when to water. And sometimes, a lot of people, I think the biggest mistake people make with orchids is that they leave their orchids in standing water, or they water too often. These plants don't like too much moisture. That's why in nature they grow in the bark of the trees. They've adapted to that. So we're basically trying to do the same thing inside a pot in our homes. But anyways, so now that I've cut the stems, and now that I've marked my leaves, I've marked my roots, let's water this plant. So this is clear water, just regular tap water. And I will just dunk it in there. I'm not going to do it overhead. I'm not going to shower it down because, remember, I don't want any water touching where I just cut the stems, because the water can have some bacteria that it will eventually get into the stems and then rot my entire plant. So I'm going to leave it in there for about 30 seconds or so. And you can see the water that came all the way up, even, you know, spilled out. That's why I have my plastic bin there. But now I'm going to wet some roots right here with some moisture, so you can see how fast they turn green. You know, they're silver right now, or white, meaning they don't have much moisture. But once that, you know, as soon as I touch them with moisture, they start turning green. That's how fast these roots react to water. So now we're going to move on to the next one. On the last white one, I did let it drain and I put it back in its ceramic pot. And now we're going to move on to the pink variety. And this variety I'm very happy with, because when I bought it, it had not too many roots, but the roots are growing just like in the white orchid. And you can see I'm going to mark the new growing leaf, just as I can, you know, I can have that as an indicator for the future to see how fast and how much my leaf has grown. And we're going to cut the stem on this plant as well. Remember, do it carefully, disinfect it. Now we're going to water this plant as well. And I'm going to show you the roots. So you can see all the new roots that have grown. A nice growing tip. Look at the color. And I believe I marked this one once already, but the root actually, instead of staying on the outside of the pot, it grew to, inward, so we're not able to see it, but I'm still going to mark all the new tips, all the, that way I can keep track, like I mentioned in the past. That's the old one I had there. I can see how fast, or just, you know, get excited once in a while when I check it. Yay, my orchid is growing. So I believe this is a very good tip, because it keeps your hopes up. And I'm also going to, you know, really mark the growing leaf as well. And once more, I'm going to fill the ceramic pot about halfway now, because I realized a little bit above that is going to cause the water to fall out. And I'm going to do this with clear water, just like I mentioned. I like to water 2 to 3 times with clear water, most of the time twice before I fertilize. And you can watch my how to fertilize video as well if you want to learn. And so I filled it all the way to the top. You can see the water there, so it's perfect. I don't want to get the stem that I just cut wet, because once again, I could get bacteria in there or other pathogens. It's like when you cut yourself, right? You put Neosporin. You try to prevent from, you know, infection. Same thing with our plant. We don't apply anything to it. We just prevent anything touching it. So these rocks right here, I use them as weights to keep my flower from falling when it had all the blooms. Now I'm just going to, you know, take them out because it doesn't need them yet until it blooms again. And you can see how fast my roots are getting that water. They're not white anymore. They're turning green. And this is a very, very good sign. And I hope you learned from this video. If you have any questions, please leave it in the comments. I'll try to make some videos regarding your comments. And anything that comes up, you know, I don't have a lot of time. I do this every day. You know, I work with millions of orchids. And, you know, it's very satisfying to show you guys how to do it at home. Thank you.